Hello, this is Ron Stallworth calling.
Well, who am I speaking with?
This is David Duke.
Grand Wizard of the Ku Klux Klan. That David Duke?
God.
Last time I checked. What can I do for you?
Well, since you asked, I hate blacks. I hate Jews, Mexicans and Irish, Italians and Chinese.
Spike, when we watch movies about racism, it's usually dark. Do you think humor, or telling a story in a humorous way, can get audience to be more related to the subject than telling it dramatically?
Some of my favorite filmmakers, Kubrick, Billy Wilder, Sid Lumet, had done films with very serious subject matters that had humor in them. Lumet, Network.
You have meddled with the primal forces of nature, Mr. Beale, and I won't have it! Is that clear?
Kubrick, Strangelove.
Mr. President, the technology required is easily within the means of even the smallest nuclear power.
Billy Wilder, Ace in the Hole.
Maybe we'll have a couple of drinks. Maybe you'll even take me out for a big evening, huh?
Why don't you wash that platinum out of your hair?
Kazan, On the Waterfront.
Edie!
Father, who'd want to kill Joey? Who'd want to kill Joey?
Well, listen, you know who the pistols are. You going to keep still until they cut you down one by one?
So this is not something that's never been done before. And I just felt that humor, that inject humor within this very serious subject matter would be a good way to tell this story.
I'm happy to be talking to a true white American.
God bless white America.
With this story, you're making social commentary about our contemporary society.
That was an intention.
That was the intention?
Yes. From the very beginning, my co-writer, Kevin Wilmot, when we got the call from Jordan Peele to do this, we knew we wanted to have audiences thinking about the present day as they watch this film that takes place in the early 70s.
We must unite and organize to fight racism!
Are you down for the liberation of black people?
Power to the people.
All power to all the people.
All power to all the people!
You also implicate the liberals, the Hollywood. When you show the movies, The Birth of Nation and Gone with the Wind, they have contributed to the establishments of those Ku Klux Klans, right?
Well, if you look at the history of cinema, which is a little over 100 years, the history of television, in many cases, those two mediums have dehumanized people, not only African Americans. Look at the Westerns, look at the films of John Wayne with John Ford. The damage they did to Native Americans, and they tried to fix it with the searches, but the damage been done before. Look how women been treated. Gay people. So there's many examples of how groups of people have been dehumanized within cinema and television.
So do you also blame Hollywood for flourishing of these
yes, because this is a very powerful medium.
America first.
America first. America first. America first.